Hello, I'm Mike. Continue the previous video part 2. In today's video, I shall share you some Excel tips on how to protect a worksheet with unlocked specific cell or arranger, and how to deeply hide the metadata sheets and lock the VBA codes view by VBA project properties. If you like watch more videos from my channel, please press subscribe button in the right bottom corner. In previous video, we have created VBA user form list box to select item in an Excel template. In the template, we need to remind users on how and where to give the inputs, such as how to make the new selection by reset selections button. We may write remind notes as, for new selection, please clear previous selection by pressing the reset selections button, or the example for user how to fill in the past folder names for saving the template, and other reminders such as for user where to fill in contact info, etc. For such text notes, we do not want user to modify or delete it accidentally. In this situation, we have to enable the Protect Worksheet feature to allow user only edit specific cells but not other parts in the worksheet. We have two ways to enable the feature. The first simple method is choose one specific editable cell for user. Right-click on it to display the dialog. Then choose the Format Cells. In Format Cells window, choose the Protection ribbon. Tick out the lock to unlock the cell. Click OK. Choose another specific cell to unlock it by same steps. Move up to the top ribbon. Under Review tab, choose the Protect Sheet, which prevents unwanted changing from others by limiting their ability to edit. Click it. In pop-up window, you may give passwords and check through the list for lock options. Then click OK. Back to the front page sheet, you may find that only two specific cells users are able to make changing. If any changing to other cells inside of this worksheet, user will get the warning message. Let me release all previous locked settings and introduce the second way. In top ribbon, under the Review tab, before protecting worksheet, we shall first to define the ranges we allow user to edit by clicking the icon of Allow Edit Ranges. By this way, you may not only have the flexible way to define ranges for user to edit, but also possible to set up permission for specific individual or group users to edit specific ranges in protected worksheet with specific password. Let's click the icon. First, we need to define the editable range from the protect sheet. Name the range. Then choose the cells from the front page for the named range. We have five cells for the range, G10, G11, G15, G19, and G20. You may do further advanced setting, create a password for people to edit the range. And who are those people? Can they edit the range with a given password or not necessarily, etc. For our demo, we just skip this permission setting and press the OK to confirm our range definition. In new window, choose Apply the defined range and click OK. Then choose the Protect Sheet to protect the front page tab with the Protect Sheet password. We have the same sheet protection feature as the first way. Do a testing with filling all inputs to the five editable cells. Now we may consider how to hide the visibility of metadata worksheets to users, such as DIM underscore account tab and admin tab, which should be only visible and maintainable by workbook creator. To enable the capability, I shall introduce two approaches. One is by using Protect Workbook, and another one is by using VBA project properties. By the second way, the template creators can not only protect the worksheets, but also block the VBA code views to other users. Before the approach creations, let me create two additional analysis worksheets for later comparison of the two approaches. By using Protect Workbook, we first need to hide the two metadata worksheets. Right-click on the Select Worksheets and choose Hide in dialog list. Then after hiding all metadata worksheets, move to top ribbon under Review tab, choose the Protect Workbook icon, which prevents others to changing the workbook structure, such as moving or deleting or adding worksheets. Give a password. Click OK. By now, we hide the specific worksheets successfully. User cannot find the two admin worksheets from the workbook without password. Even the hide and unhide both options are disabled to users. What if user want to add a new worksheet or rearrange the visible worksheets for their own needs? All creators do not want others to see and modify their macros and VBA procedures. For those needs, we may apply the approach by using VBA project properties to deep hidden admin worksheets and same time to block the VBA code view to others. Let's release the Protect Workbook setting we have done before and reset the visibilities for all worksheets. Move to top ribbon, choose Developer tab, click the Visual Basic icon. If we browse the Project Explorer, we can see all worksheets in list. If we click the View Code, we can see all VBA procedures in Code View window. To deep hide the metadata or admin sheets, in VBA Project Explorer window, choose and click the sheet object, for example, DIM_account. Then in below object property window, we see the last list field box visible. In the drop-down list, choose very hidden option. Repeat the steps for admin sheet. Then move to the top ribbon under tools. In dialog list, choose the VBA project properties. In project properties window, choose the protection section. Tick on the lock project for view. Create and confirm the password. Then OK, close the setting. Move to the Excel window and save and close the Excel template. Reopen the Excel file. Then user may not able to see the hided two worksheets, but compared to Protect Workbook approach, they can hide the other analyze sheets. They can also add the new sheets if they required. But if user want to the two hided sheets visible again and view the VBA codes, they have to get the password to reopen VBA project properties window to do the resetting. By now, I have shared the video on how to protect a worksheet with unlocked specific cells, and how to deeply hide the metadata worksheets and lock the VBA codes by VBA project properties. In next video, I shall demonstrate the way to create a VBA procedure to save file name with naming convention according to the inputs given by user in the Excel template. Thanks for watching. If you like to watch more video from the channel, please press the subscriber button in below. See you in next video.